For once, researchers in Keene UST, in Ghana, and the sub-region as a whole can start to dream. Right now, you are not limited by the absence of equipment. So in times past, usually, whatever project you decide to do, you are limited by the fact that, you know, can I do all my analysis in this country, in my lab, in my school? Those are issues that plague researchers. But currently, the equipment are there, they are all functioning, they are state of the art. You can find those equipment, they are comparable to any equipment you can find in any of the big universities anywhere in the world. So the idea of a central lab is a brainchild of the Vice Chancellor, Professor William Otuelis. And what he thought of was that instead of individual departments trying to buy equipment to do their research, equipment that they couldn't afford sometimes, it would be better if we could put all those equipments which have which have applications in various disciplines at one central facility where everybody can come and use it. In that way, the cost is for each department comes down because it's at a central facility. And so that was the idea. So there are equipment over here that spans both the basic and applied sciences. So people in chemistry, in biology, biochemistry, food science and technology, in the medical school, people in pharmacy, in agric, they all have equipment over here that they can use to do the work that they are involved in. In actual fact, the liquid chromatograph mass spectrometer that we have is the only one in the sub-region. The world of West Africa is the only one that exists over here. In addition to the facilities in this block, we have other satellite labs where some of the equipment are located. So when you go to the Department of Horticulture in the Faculty of Agric, there is a greenhouse that sits over there, and the greenhouse permits you to be able to control the conditions for growing your plant. We have students who are doing their master's degree that use this lab. People doing their PhDs use this lab. So the students can either be from KNUST or from other universities in Ghana. So we have students from the University of Ghana, University of Cape Coast, University for Development Studies all coming over here to do some work. We also have students coming from outside Ghana within the sub-region. And so a couple of weeks ago, we had about 5 requests from students in Nigeria who wanted to come and characterize their compounds right here at the KNUST Central Lab. Apart from academia, people in industry also use this place. So Goldfields Limited, for instance, are trying to look at the presence or absence of heavy metals in their soil samples at the places where they operate. And so they came over here to use our atomic absorption spectrophotometer for that work. And so people in industry, in academia, and people who are the regulatory bodies, so the Environmental Protection Agency, for instance, does some work over here, the Food and Drugs Board, the Ghana Science Authority, they all use this place. So the lab charges, there are lab charges for using equipment over here. The reason is so that we can maintain the equipment that we have over here, because one of the problems in Africa is that people are unable to maintain the equipment that they have. So we need to be able to maintain our equipment so that this nice shiny equipment that you see here today, they do not become obsolete in a couple of years. For Africa to develop, it's important that we are able to answer questions that are related, are peculiar to Africa. We have to answer, or we have to solve African problems. And to do that, we need state-of-the-art equipment. And so KNUST have taken the lead, and I believe every university in Ghana, in Africa, should follow this lead.